Hello, I'm Gavin Hoey, and in this video tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can create this, the Drosti effect. Now, what is it? Well, first of all, it's sort of a spiraling image that just disappears forevermore. And it starts with a picture of the clock on my office wall. Yep, it really is the clock on my office wall. So how do we go from that to this? Well, we're going to use a filter, and it's called Pixel Bender. Now, it's been around for a while in Adobe Labs, but to get it, you have to physically go to Adobe Labs, download it, and install it. And when you do, you'll find it down here. Now, if you don't know how to install it, follow the link on screen, and I've got a video tutorial explaining exactly how it's done. Now, once you've installed Pixel Bender, you need to go and get the Drosti filter. So that's another quick trip back to the internet, and you're going to type into your favorite search engine, Pixel Bender Exchange, and it'll take you here to the Adobe Exchange. Now in Pixel Bender Exchange, just click on the most popular filter, and guess what the most popular filter is? Yep, that's right, it's the Drosti effect. So you're going to download it, unzip it, and you just need to pop it in the right part of your computer. There's full instructions on the site, but for me on a Windows machine, it's in the C, Program Files, Adobe, and then whichever version of Photoshop you've installed. You'll find the Pixel Bender files there, as long as you've installed Pixel Bender, of course. And I can just right-click in here and paste the Pixel Bender filter, which is a PBK or dial-up phone book, which is kind of a bit confusing. Just ignore the file type. Honestly, it really is a Pixel Bender filter. Right, okay, that's the boring technical bit out of the way. Let's get on with the interesting bit. Let's actually create the image. So first thing I need to do is make a selection. I'm just going to make a rough selection of the background because that's nice and easy to select. But I don't want the actual background selected, so I will inverse it to select the clock face. Now, down to the keyboard, Command or Control J, just to duplicate that layer like that. And now I have a new layer. I can actually dump the original background, and it just has the clock face on it. Right, we don't need all this excess sort of empty pixel stuff here, so I'm going to go to Image and choose Trim, and I will trim off the transparent pixels, which is quite a large part of the picture gone. Now, I do need to know the exact dimensions of this picture. It's actually really important for the filter when we come to it, because we're going to have to enter these dimensions in. So I could just go and check the image size, but I'm just going to grab my crop tool. I've got a preset of 2,500 pixels in both width and height, and that means I can actually control things a little bit more. You don't have to do this, but it just gives me that little extra edge of control. So there we go, that is now exactly 2,500 pixels in both width and height. Right, now let's go to the filter and Pixel Bender and Pixel Bender Gallery. Now, Pixel Bender Gallery, well, there are plenty of different effects for you to play with in Pixel Bender. If you've never experienced any of them, just go and have a look at some of these effects because they are absolutely wild. But the one we're interested in is the one we installed, the Drosti effect. And this is what you'll get when you first load up the Drosti Pixel Bender filter. Now, remember I said about the size being important? Well, now we're going to enter those size right in here, 2,500 by 2,500. Your picture doesn't have to be square, of course, but just happens to suit mine quite nicely. And as soon as you enter those in, instantly it works. And it's fabulous. I mean, nothing else needs changing. You could just stop there quite happily. But I'm just going to run down a few of these sliders. I'm not going to cover them all because there's lots there and not all of them are that useful. And hey, besides, having a play with them is part of the fun of learning. The inner radius is the next one to look at because that will just change the effect. And you can see how as I move the inner radius around, it just spins the whole thing around. Ooh, kind of weird. I'm thinking probably around about there is going to be about right, I think. Maybe, yeah. where do you stop? Let's go for around about 30. The periodicity is the next one I'm going to change. If you have a look at the hands of the clock, you can see the big hand is pointing straight up. Sorry, I have kids. And in all of the pictures, they kind of line up. So I don't really want them all lining up. I think I would like just to break up that symmetry a little bit. And to do that, I'm going to change the periodicity. And if I move it around, you'll see it just spins the pictures about. And I probably want something like 1.1 or somewhere in that area. That'll do. 1.08. So a tiny difference. But if you notice now, this hand is still on the 12 and this one's still on the 12. But they're not in line anymore. I've just sort of shifted them almost sort of one step out, as it were. And that works just fine. Strands. Now you'll see we have just a single coil rolling down there, which is actually the effect that I want. But if I increase my strands to 2 or 3, your eye will have a sort of double spiral or triple spiral or as many spirals as you like. And similarly, if you put it into negative numbers, your spirals will go the other way. I don't really want it negative, so I shall just keep it on the default of 1. Zoom and rotate. Well, they do pretty much what they say. You can zoom in, keep zooming in on the picture like that, which isn't quite what I want this time. Or I can rotate this around, and that's actually going to work better for me. I think a bit of rotation works quite nicely. I'm going to put it about there, I think. So the sort of second clock in, if you like, is the right way up. And next one down of usefulness is the centering. So the centering allows me to recenter the picture physically in the frame, but the center shift will let me shift where the Droste effect centers on the picture. So I can have pushing it, I can have it off to the side or well, whatever I want. And I think just slightly, just a tiny little bit off like that is just going to, again, break up the effect slightly more. Now I've lost the top there, so I think I'm just going to use the center here. We'll just bring that back in. There we go, something like that. And I think that's probably as good as we're going to get. Yep, that's looking. There we go. And I like that. That sits just in the corner, just in the right place. Now, there are plenty of other sliders that you can play with on the Pixel Bender in the Droste filter. Go and have a little look and you can create some truly wild effects. But I'm happy with that, so I'm just going to click OK. And that's basically it. That is my effect completed. If I want to, I can just go and have a look at something like levels, for example, and maybe just brighten my picture up a little bit and just give it a bit more contrast, something like that. You can do whatever you want to do on your picture from now on. So you can apply all of your standard Photoshop effects as you wish. But the basic effect to create is using the Pixel Bender filter. Okay, so there you go. There's how you create your very own Droste effect. If you want to find out more about me, visit my website at www.gavtrain.com. I'm Gavin Hoey. Thanks for watching.